Was there one thing? I mean, we lost a lot of people, and when Eddie Guerrero passed away, he was a good friend of mine, and that really bothered me a lot, and it made me really think a lot about life. Was there one thing that happened to you that thought, you know what, time to get clean? I've got a life ahead of me.
There was not an incident. I remember I had been, believe you me, this company, and people can say what they want, and I'm toeing the line, and I'm a company man and all that, but this company literally saved my life, sent me to rehab 4 or 5 times on their dime, and it just so happened.
4 or 5 times?
Yes, yes. And I mean, I've been going since.
Why did the last time stick?
And I think it's totally up to the individual where it's time for me to quit. It's time. I can't continue living like this. Like, I cannot go on living my life like this, because I got bad. I was unemployed. I was a drug addict, and I contemplated suicide, like, a lot. Like, and the only reason I didn't go forth with that was that my wife or my children would find my brains blown out in the shed out back. You know what I mean? And so that was the reason I told myself, don't do that. And so I got sick of living like that. And so it wasn't a spiritual revelation or anything. It was just, I don't want to live like that anymore. And then I found out, if you work this program of recovery, you don't have to live like that anymore.
Do you look back and think, man, if I just would have been sober in 95, the run I could have had?
Yeah, I do. But here's the difference. If I dwell on the negative of that, then I'm aiming towards a bar or towards a pill.
Right.
If I use that as, if you saw the water boy, Bobby Boucher, if I use that fact as tackling fuel to attack my sobriety, then it becomes a strong asset instead of a negative past. I know I've neglected my children because of drug addiction. I know I've neglected my wife because of drug addiction. I cannot change that.
But you can change
today. But what I can do is never do it again. And that's where I stand today.